been talking a lot about making use of local development tools to assist in building your WordPress website. If you're planning your website project and don't want to feel rushed into paying for hosting or anything like that, local development is the perfect place to start. In our last lesson, we explained some huge benefits of working locally. The first one, save on cost. Number two, benefits from speed and performance. And number three, minimizing your risk by testing absolutely everything locally before you take your site live. We've also shown a number of widely used options that are available, but in this lesson, we're going to hone in on one, and it's my favorite. Hi, I'm Ryan. Thanks for joining us at the Learning Hub. Let's talk about Local WP. I've been using Local WP, or formerly known as Local by Flywheel, ever since it launched. It makes working locally so easy. Honestly, you can get your site up and running with only a few clicks. But don't just take my word for it. Let's download it together and install. To get started, head over to localwp.com or search for Local WP in Google. From there, click the download for free link. Select your platform, enter your info, and hit get it now. Once downloaded, open the installer. For me, I'm on a Mac, so I'm simply dragging the app into my applications folder. If you're on a different platform, simply follow the on-screen instructions. And we're literally done installing. From here, let's open Local and set up our very first website. From the very get-go, we're given the options to create a new site. Before we jump in, let's take a look around. You might remember that in our last lesson, we mentioned that Local WP is developed by the team at Flywheel and WP Engine. And if you end up choosing one of these as your hosting platforms, you get the added bonus of being able to connect to your account and push up or pull down any of your websites from your account. This is a very, very helpful feature. The next tab includes a bunch of add-ons that can install and assist with your website build. And the final tab gives us some helpful links if you were to run into any trouble. So let's head back to our local sites tab and click create a new site. First step is simply to give our site a new name. I'm going to keep with my Ryan's Recipes idea. This thing is going to take off. You watch. Next, it allows us to set a local domain name that we want to use, remembering that this is only accessible from our computer, but it still makes sense to keep it simple and clean. I'm going to simply remove the hyphen to clean this up. The local site path is where on our computer we want local to store our actual WordPress files. This defaults to our documents folder. Next option they give us is to choose a blueprint. As this is our very first time using local, we haven't saved any blueprints, but this is a really super handy tool for when you get to a point where you've got your favorite list of themes, plugins, and settings. You can simply create a blueprint of your website and then create countless more based on this setup. It saves a bunch of time. So from here, we hit continue. Next step is to choose our environment. Generally speaking, we wouldn't normally have a reason to make changes here. However, if you already have a hosting environment, it would make a lot of sense to mirror your server configurations so that you know that what you test and run locally would also function as expected on your live site. You'd simply talk to your hosting support if you weren't sure how to find what version of PHP you were running or what version of MySQL you're working with. We're going to stick with the preferred settings at this point. Let's hit continue. Final step is to set up our WordPress admin account by entering our username, password, and email. There is an advanced option here that allows us to set up WordPress as a multi-site, but we're going to leave this one alone for the time being. Let's hit add site and watch as local works its magic. It goes through its final setup and boom, we have our site. We can see here the site domain that we set up and it gives us the option if we ever decided to change this down the track. Skipping down a little further, we have a feature that allows us to automatically log into a WordPress admin area without having to fill in the login form. This is a great time-saving feature to take advantage of if you wish. From here, we can head over to our website's admin and begin building. Add a new page, install a theme or plugin, and get creating. Local WP really is an amazing tool to get started with local development. If, however, you're looking to dig your teeth in a little deeper, our next lesson will go through how to install and set up XAMPP. As always, if you haven't yet, make sure you join Elemental's vibrant community and check out the Academy and blog. Catch you in lesson 10.